Hello, I'm Philip Stoughton for ID People. I'm here at Wise Media's 6th EMEA Summit in Abu Dhabi, and I'm joined by Toma Nikolic from Vlatacom. Toma, thank you very much for joining me. Very kind. Start by giving me a brief introduction to the company, and then we'll start to talk a bit about the products.
Vlatacom is a Serbian company specialized in security of information. We are system integrator and solution provider in fields of communication, document production, border management. Last several years we are focused on two fancy statements, two fields, e-government, safe city. We produce in-house our own hardware like full page passport readers, capable to read also visa stickers and ID cards. We have small devices for strong biometric authentication of people, for logon and login and access control. We utilize existing core biometric technologies like face recognition, fingerprint recognition, and we integrate them in the solution as per client's technical requirements and available budget.
Yeah.
So we are trying always to tailor solution to fit both technical specs and financial budgets requirements. We are established in Serbia in 1997. It was a difficult time. It was UN, US and Motorola sanctions against Yugoslavia because of civil war. But our target was to become distributor of Motorola for Yugoslav market, which we achieved in 1998. We had first success on Serbian market in 2001, and it was conventional radio equipment from Motorola. And in 2002, we had first big success in regard to biometrics. It was delivery of face and finger recognition system to Serbian MOI, Ministry of Interior. Since then, we figured out that we have to enter into the research and to the development, because for every client you need to do customization of solution and you need to localize it to local culture, language, alphabet. And we since then have integrated at the first place solution capable to collect demographic and biometric data from the cities and when they apply for ID and travel documents. And it's a part of overall solution end to end, from collection of data, their storing, workflow of approval, data preparation for personalization, printing of documents, quality assurance and issuing. So it's end-to-end.
End-to-end solutions. And you talked about e-government and smart city, and we're using the term e in front of as many things as we can, and we're putting smart in front of as many things as we can. But essentially, they can be very similar things. Does that mean that most of your clients are governments or municipalities?
You are right. Our target are government and governmental institutions and, let's say, municipalities, since we refer also to safe city, they are in charge to monitor and to control a situation. With the government, we work with secure encrypted digital communication systems for them, systems for finger and face recognition, systems for issuing of personal travel documents. We also have products in regard to border control, I mean passengers on the border crossings, and also control of green border line, but it's not focus of this event, so I won't spend time on this. For the municipalities, safe city is activity where they are active, of course, number one to finance solutions. So in the safe city, we provide video of surveillance of the streets and of the, how to say, pavements. So we can detect existence of the vehicles in the street, which is like an input for traffic management done by control of traffic lights. We turn on and off traffic lights for pedestrians and for the vehicles in order to optimize throughput of vehicles to this planary grid of streets. On the other side, you can use these video cameras to read number plates from the cars, to do face recognition if some persons mm-hmm. are listed or wanted. And also, we have a product related to traffic violation registration.
Right.
Like
okay.
drive-through red,
yeah.
Speeding,
yeah.
and driving in a lane dedicated for public transport.
Okay. Okay.
And I don't want to show off, but Belgrade municipality has our solution, and the return of investment was 3 months.
Wow.
And on the other side, effect of public knowledge that system is introduced is like that they added, in addition to existing 1,100 buses, 200 buses more.
Right.
So in brief, people stopped driving yellow lane for public yeah. transportation.
Yeah.
So it's contribution to municipality, and at the first place, contribution by a reduced number of casualties,
yeah.
of injuries, of
yeah.
damage on vehicles, on infrastructure, and at the end of the day,
yeah.
hospital days.
Yeah.
Every of our activities is related to security and safety. When we speak about documents, document production, passenger facilitation on border crossings, we utilize PKI entirely developed in-house.
Right.
Starting from certification authorities mm-hmm. and all PKI infrastructure, all the way to the applets in the chip of the
yeah.
document.
Okay.
And we are very proud of
yeah.
this. Most of these solutions are based on open platform,
right.
but our implementation.
Yeah, very good.
We started as a team of 7 people, and today we have 100 people full-time employed and 100 working on contract. And I hope this will continue to grow.
Wow, it's
among
impressive
full-time
growth.
Employed staff, we have 7 PhDs
right.
and 50 Masters of Science.
Wow.
And 2 years ago, our government have recognized Vlatacom as a research and development center. This year we will, inshallah, mm-hmm. we will become a research and development institute. And our plan is, of course, to continue and to expand our R&D mm. activities, and also to use our license to educate people from abroad for Masters
yeah.
of Science and PhD degrees in regard to security
yeah.
and encryption, safe city government. And we hope that when people have more information and knowledge, it will be easier for us to find a counterpart to discuss about good features
yeah.
of our
yeah.
approach and
yeah.
our solutions.
Yeah, because you educate the market. And in terms of where that market is, you're obviously having a lot of success back home, but what
yes.
about on the international basis?
Serbia is a small country. It's only 8 million people. And we started to build our brand name and to work abroad in 2005. And since then we are participating. I think our first participation to ID World was in Milano in 2006.
Okay.
And then again in 2007, 8, and we were here also 2 years ago
okay.
for ID World Abu
yeah.
Dhabi. And we are very happy to be here.
Yeah.
Our opinion is that this was good event, that we networked with the people from other companies
yeah.
and we met some people from local institutions
yeah.
and we are very grateful for people from Vice Media to organize this event.
Yeah. Okay.
On the other countries, we are present in Angola, in Nigeria and few other countries.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, in Angola we have big project with the traffic
with
management.
The government.
We
yeah.
we control 210 crossroads, which have more than 2,000 traffic lights, and we use more than 1,300 video surveillance
right.
cameras to make connectivity to the center with all these wide communication
yeah.
streams. We utilized and installed more than 110 kilometers of
mm-hmm.
fiber optics in urban city area.
Right.
Luanda is more than 5 million people with suburbs.
Yeah.
And it was designed maybe for 500,000 of people. So our success is even bigger having in
yeah.
mind that it's not designed and prepared for such a how to say aggressive installation of infrastructure.
And certainly those urban environments are giving you more and more opportunity. Africa is creating more and more opportunity in itself, so being there is really important.
Yes, in Africa we recognize that people pay more and more attention to security and to build capacity of their people. And in Nigeria, that I mentioned as our clients, last 5 years we are partner of Nigeria Immigration Service, where they utilize our solution for passenger registration on the border crossings that covers international airports in Abuja, Lagos, Kano, and Port Harcourt. And we delivered also front-end applications.
Okay.
We do rapid, fast reading of full-page reading of electronic passports, optical with white UV and infrared light. We are reading chip data, check validity of certificates against ICAO PKD.
Okay.
We do fast queries and searches through local watch lists, stop lists, how to send some other things. And we submit information immediately over communication channels to headquarters of Nigerian Immigration Service. And we hope that this system will be, how to say, recommended to other neighbors.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
Nigeria is the most important country in ECOWAS, at least, which is West African Country Union.
Well, certainly some exciting opportunities there. Exciting opportunities with the products, lots going on. Toma, thank you very much for talking to me. Thank you for your time.
You're most welcome. Thank you for inviting me.
I hope
me
we can do this again. Thank you.